everyone. My name is Andrea Masterton, Vice President of Marketing with POCA. Physical distancing is the main strategy being used by manufacturing facilities to keep workers safe. That means only those deemed essential to keep production running are allowed on site, while support staff mainly works from home. Every shift essentially now looks like third shift, with limited resources available at hand to answer questions and solve problems as they arise. And production issues are more likely than ever to occur, especially at those companies who have repurposed production to address new demand created by COVID, switching production lines to build new products in record-breaking time. Or even for those companies that are facing workforce turnover and as a result need to bring on new workers to replace those that are sick or in quarantine. And that's why having timely access to equipment and other subject matter experts is so important. We've created this short video demonstration to show you how POCA can help digitally connect frontline workers and give them the ability to collaborate safely and remotely with those experts to troubleshoot and manage issues.
Jeff Lamb starts his shift as an operator by logging into POCA using a tablet at his workstation. The first thing Jeff does is check the factory feed for the latest news and production updates. Both management and frontline workers use the factory feed to share critical information, such as shift reports and maintenance notifications, and, as we're about to see, identify, escalate, and collaborate on production issues. When Jeff experiences a problem with his machine, a case packer, he first checks to see if there's a troubleshooting solution already documented. He grabs his tablet and uses POCA to scan a QR code on the side of the case packer. This opens a library of work instructions, troubleshooting tips, and other documentation for the machine. He finds a troubleshooting video that was posted by a coworker who experienced the very same issue a few weeks earlier. He watches his coworker explaining how to change the pins, and then he follows the step-by-step guide to get the case packer working properly again. Because all troubleshooting tips are accessible at Jeff's workstation and videos are easier to understand than printed instructions, it takes Jeff a fraction of the time to fix the problem and avoid additional waste. Later in the shift, he notices a post from Lisa Allen. She's experiencing a problem with the wrapper not cutting properly. Because no troubleshooting solution exists yet, Lisa has posted a call for help in the factory feed. The post includes a video that she took using her tablet to demonstrate the problem and other vital information needed to resolve it, such as problem type, equipment, and location. By tagging the post in this way, all designated experts for the machine were automatically notified of the problem. This includes workers across shifts, departments, and even plants. Her co-workers then sprang into action. 24 people viewed the post and several provided feedback. Because Lisa had posted a video of the problem, remote experts working in other plants and locations were able to easily understand the problem and offer a solution. Nathan, for example, suggested that the seal discs may need tightening. To Lisa's delight, his advice worked, and another production issue was resolved quickly with minimal disruption. Now let's look at how management uses POCA to assign, track, and manage production issues. Sam Brown, a production supervisor, logs into POCA using his laptop. He goes to the digital Kanban board to find an at-a-glance view of all newly opened, pending, in progress, and resolved issues. He can then quickly see the status of each issue in real time and follow up and escalate issues without the need for a face-to-face conversation or stand-up meeting. Sam goes into Lisa's call for help to see if he needs to take any action. In the discussion thread, he sees a comment and photo from Nathan offering a solution to the problem. He then tags the problem as solved, which then changes the status to resolved. He then converts the post into a troubleshooting solution in the knowledge base. This ensures everyone can learn what to do and quickly solve the problem on their own if it ever happens to them. All videos, photos, and documents that were shared by experts and workers are then automatically added to the troubleshooting solution. The solution is labeled a draft until approved by all required stakeholders. Once approved, it then becomes available to all workers assigned to that equipment. Sam goes back to the digital Kanban board to look for other issues that need his attention. He can then filter the calls for help by plant location and production line, and then quickly see the status of other issues that require an action. For example, in Benjamin Jones's post, he sees that 5 people have responded and 3 people have been assigned to the call for help, yet the issue remains unresolved after 65 days. This prompts Sam to escalate the issue and send a reminder notification to everyone involved.
So as you just saw, by digitally connecting frontline workers, POCA eliminates the need for face-to-face interaction in order to solve problems and share knowledge. Issues can be easily escalated with the help of photo, videos, and text through calls for help in POCA's factory feed. And this is not only going to keep workers safe, but it's going to help solve problems in record-breaking time, contributing ultimately to plant productivity and efficiency. If you're interested in learning more, please come and visit us at www.poca.io, and stay safe and be well.